Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, we're going to take a look at the Smith & Wesson Model 586 L Comp revisited in 2022. Just staying the course, we're going to take a look at some more revolvers before the year is over. And I wanted to bring out the 586 L Comp just to ramble and babble about it because, like I said, we're talking revolvers. So this is a really cool revolver because I consider this revolver to be the Glock 19 of wheelies. I definitely think this is a combat style revolver. I think this would serve anybody well because this is an L frame 357 Magnum 7-shot out of the performance center. This is cut for moon clips, pretty cool, even though I don't use moon clips. Full length ejector rod on this one. And this revolver here works out very well. It's very smooth. It's out of the performance center. Double action rolling on this trigger here is very smooth. I love that thing. I don't shoot in single action ever, but why not? So that's single action. Pretty light. No trigger over travel because they hammered in that trigger stop back there. So this is a very, very cool revolver. Has that compensator right up here on the barrel. It definitely works. It definitely keeps the muzzle down and there's not as much muzzle rise when shooting full house 357 Magnum loads out of this thing. Full carbon steel frame. It's awesome. Again, you can shoot full house Magnum loads out of this thing with no issues. Very cool. And again, out of the performance center. Now, I actually was just shooting this at we were shooting rifle, ARs, and this was my handgun that was holstered on my belt. So it was interesting because the younger crowd there, when I was shooting rifle, I would transition to this handgun right here. They thought I was joking, being a clown, you know, being an idiot. They're like, come on, man, where's your Glock? Where's your SIG? You know, where's your whatever? So when I was transitioning to this as my primary handgun, I guess that people didn't take too kindly to it, which is really weird. It's very, very strange nowadays with the younger crowd. I'm talking about the 25-year-olds to 35-year-olds, that range. Now, I wanted to carry this revolver at that rifle, shoot because this was the handgun of choice, you know? I wasn't trying to be funny. Wasn't trying to be, a clown, as one guy said. He said, come on, man, you don't carry a revolver. Why are you doing that? Let's be serious here. We're training. Yeah, these are the 25-year-old experts in AR-15 tactics and moving around with them. They love running around with it with all their gear on and using all the cool terms nowadays, which I don't understand. They love to have their phones out, taking pictures for Instagram and Reddit, all that kind of good stuff, I guess. And it's just turned into, I don't know. I just don't understand it. So maybe I should just stick to myself, you know. the young crowd of today, the gun community with the youngsters, I just don't get it, man. But anyways, I was using this. I would transition from AR-15, my primary rifle, to this, and it worked out just fine. You know, this thing is a great handgun. I still believe that if you're looking for a primary revolver for carry, this could be it. Now, it's pretty heavy. Okay, this is a heavy revolver. But yes, this can be a primary, you know, if you want to call it concealed carry or duty revolver. 7 shots of 357 Magnums. That's no joke. So this thing shoots very well. I like it a lot. And now it doesn't have a really usable front sight. It's supposed to be a night sight up there, but you can barely see it. Now, I actually do have DNL Sports, I think it was a rear fixed sight that just pops in right here, and an XS big dot sight that would pop in up here. I would have to punch out that roll pin, kind of drill that hole out a little bit bigger, then I could put a new front sight in. However, I cannot find for the life of me where the freaking sights are, and I'm a little upset that they're nowhere to be found. It's kind of like, what the hell happened here? Now, granted, I haven't been into revolvers in quite some time, all right? Just these past few months, I started getting back into the wheel gun. Now, I got those two sights probably a couple of years ago, and I just put them away. I had the intention of installing them on here, but then things shifted, you know, interest kind of shift. My gun room is filled with AR-15 parts and just tools, and I, in the drawer that I thought I had, where these sights would be, they're not there. I don't know if I gave them to somebody. I gave them away, possibly. I can't remember. But I'm going to continue to see if I can find those sights and finally install them on this 586 Elcom. If I don't have them, I may have given them away. Then, oh well, no big deal. I'll just leave this revolver as is, because all this revolver is a range gun only. Yes, I could carry this as a primary CCW, but I won't. That's a 1911 for me. But this is just a range gun for collectability. I like it. It's a lot of fun to shoot. It's easy to shoot. And when my buddies want to go out and shoot a revolver, this is one of the revolvers I'll take out to let them handle it and have fun with. But yeah, this is a really cool revolver, like I said. These grips are made by, what are these again? These grips are made by Nil. I do have a few more of these grips on some other Smith & Wesson revolvers. There was a time where I got a few of these in, and I put them on some of my Smith & Wessons. So, yeah, these are very, very good grips, ergonomically very correct. I like them. They look a little big for a 3-inch revolver, like these specific model. I don't know what the model is, but it's kind of like a squared off butt, this is really a round butt. But I think it, you know, makes it look cool. But these finger grooves are exact. This groove right here, exact for the thumb. I love it. It's just, you can control this revolver very, very well with these grips, these Nil grips. I don't know why I drew a blank for a second there. Nil grips, awesome grips. Like I said, I got a few of them a couple of years ago, and I put them on some of my Smith revolvers, and they just look awesome, and they are incredibly functional. I mean, look at these grips. You can't even see the seam right there. Looks seamless. See that? Looks like one piece of wood, but they're two panels. We call them stocks. I should call them revolver stocks, not grips. But it's like seamless. Can't even see that. It's awesome. See that? Really cool. And they actually look very, very nice. The wood color and everything. But again, the most important thing is they're incredibly functional. Awesome grips. So I'll show you, you know, some little bit of range footage of me shooting this 586 Elcom at the range. So here you go. Alright, we're going to try some critical duty. This is a 135 grain magnum. Normally I don't use this through a 3-inch, but I have a bunch of this stuff that I just want to kind of shoot up. So here, we're going to try these. Very easy to control. But it's a lot louder, and you can kind of feel it, but not bad at all through the Elcom. Not bad at all. All right, so more 357 Magnums. Here we go. One-handed. Weak hand. Whoa, this is tough. One shot. So these Nil grips really, really, really help control the revolver, and I think for a felt recoil as well for 357 Magnums. So, okay, we're gonna do some 158 grain Magnums. Okay. That one didn't seem like it should have recoiled more. Okay, we're gonna do 7 more shots at 357 Magnum. very controllable, like I said, with the nil grips and the comp on the top. So
just a little bit of footage of me shooting this fine revolver. Now, speed loaders. I used to have SL variant 7-shot loaders, but I sold them on eBay many, many years ago. I wish I kept them, but I did not. For the time being, I'm actually using a 5-star speed loader. Like, this has snap caps in there. But the 5-star speed loader still sounds like a maraca. These aren't not my favorites, but not too many places make a 7-shot loader. I mean, HKS does, but I mean, HKS's are a classic, and I don't know, they're not my favorite, I guess. So the 5-shot works just like this. You just drop it in and you spin it, and it loads just like that. I don't know, why is this orange? I don't remember why. So that's pretty cool, I guess. You can still load this pretty quickly. Not a big fan of moon clips, unless I have to use moon clips, like if it was a 9mm or a 45 ACP, you have no choice, you gotta use moon clips. That's fine. But for a 357 Magnum, I still prefer, if I can, a speed loader. So for now, I have a few of these 5-shot, 7-round speed loaders. And yeah, they are orange. I don't remember why they sent orange, but anyways, these work out, you know, they're fine, but they do sound like a maraca. So there you go, guys. I don't want to make this video too long. It's just a revisit in 2022 on the 586 L Comp. Really cool revolver. I think it's an awesome revolver, and I know they're still making them. So if you're interested in a serious use, okay, 357 Magnum 7-shot for carry, take a look at this. Definitely take a look at this model. I know a lot of people like the carry comp instead, and I think that one's fine too. It looks almost identical to this. So that'll just be up to you. But anyways, here it is, the 586 L Comp. Still looking good. You definitely got to get rid of these sights though if you're going to carry it, because they're not really that usable for concealed carry. But yeah, with a 3-inch barrel. Very nice. All right, guys, you can leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.